Okay, now let us discuss one more question, and this question is related to cache mapping techniques. So in a cache memory, there are different types of mappings like direct mapping, okay, associate mapping and set associate mapping. So many questions came in the previous GATE exam related to the set associate mapping. So one of the question related to this set associate mapping we will discuss. This is also one of the previous GATE question asked for 2 marks, okay. Just to have an idea what type of questions are coming and how to solve it, okay. Because if you solve many of the GATE, previous GATE papers and also some other important questions which are given in some previous years and also the textbooks. So in textbooks, after every chapter, there will be some exercise problems. So many questions from Morris Menno textbook, the questions are selected, even directly some questions are given in the GATE exam also, okay. So this is the size of the physical address space of a processor is 2 power p bytes. The word length is 2 power w bytes. The capacity of the cache memory is 2 power n bytes. The size of each cache block is 2 power m words. For a k-way set associative cache memory, the length in the number of bits of the tag field is dash. So we need to find out the tag field, how many bits are used for the tag field. Okay. You know that in a set associate mapping, we will divide the total main memory address into 3 parts, tag, set offset and word offset. Word offset related to the block. Block and line both are same here, okay. So the size of physical address space is 2 power p bytes. That means every physical address contains p bits. We can identify one word of main memory using the p bits if there are 2 power p words, but here there are 2 power p bytes. So now let us solve this problem. So here what happens is, first of all, you have to take the total physical address and then we need to divide them into 3 parts, okay. So here this is the physical address in set associate mapping. This physical address is containing p bits because you can identify 1 byte of main memory using the p bits if there are 2 power p bytes, and this has been divided into 3 parts. One is the tag followed by set offset, set offset followed by word offset, set offset followed by word offset. These are the 3 categories. Now the size of the physical address space is 2 power p bytes. Based on that, it is decided the word length is 2 power w bytes. The capacity of the cache memory is 2 power n bytes and the size of the cache block is 2 power m words, okay. First, cache block size you convert into word bytes. So cache word is equal to, cache word is equal to, there are 2 power m words, and what is the one word size? The word length is 2 power w bytes. So 2 power m into 2 power w bytes. So bases are same, we can add this powers. So 2 power m plus w bytes. That means to identify 1 byte in the block, we require m plus w bits. So that is word offset is identified. Word or byte offset. If it's a word addressable memory, it's a word offset. If it's a byte addressable memory, we have to take the byte offset. Okay. Now we have to find out number of words, because number of sets can be identified using the number of words. How many words are there in the cache? Number of blocks. Number of blocks is equal to size of the cache divided by size of the block. What is the size of the cache? It is given as cache memory size is 2 power n bytes. So this is 2 power n divided by size of the particular block. This is not a size of the word. Size of the word is identified in the form of bytes, okay. So now number of blocks, if you wanted to know, we have to divide the cache size divided by block size. So size of the block is 2 power m words. M words is converted into bytes, okay. So now size of word is given as 2 power m plus w bytes, and the word length is 2 power w, okay. Now in the form of bytes, if you find out the word size, that is the 2 power m plus w. So this is number of blocks is equal to cache size divided by block size. So this is also called as a block in the form of words. Okay. So now this will be 2 power n minus m minus w. 2 power n minus m minus w is the size of the number of blocks. That means each block can be identified using n minus m minus w bits. Okay. So that is clearly given. The cache memory size is 2 power n. Size of the each cache block is 2 power m words. M words is identified using the bytes. Okay. This is the block size. Block size. So block size is 2 power m plus w. That is why we have divided the cache size with the block size to find out the number of blocks. Now we need to find out the number of sets. So there is a formula. Number of sets is equal to number of blocks divided by n for n way set associative. So this is the k way set associative. So this is 2 power n minus m minus w divided by k, because it is a k way set associative. So that we can take this as a log k base 2 to identify the number of bits. So we can say that it is 2 power n minus m minus w minus log k base 2. This is the number of sets. That means to identify one set, that is this part, can be identified using n minus m minus w minus log k base 2. Okay, now we can calculate here now. Okay, so how to calculate? Let us see. Because our intention is to find out the number of tag bit field. Okay, so now tag bit field we do not know. Set offset will be n minus. To identify one set, we require n minus m minus w minus log k base 2, log k base 2 plus word offset. How many words are there? Okay, one word size is 2 power w bytes. Okay, and then there are 2 power m plus w bytes in the block. So to identify one byte, we require m plus w. This is m plus w. So the entire P is this, and set offset is this part, and word offset is this part. If you subtract from P these two, then you will get the tag bits. So that means it is a P minus of these two. Now this will become P minus N plus M plus W plus log k base 2 minus m minus w. Now this m is cancelled, m is cancelled, w is cancelled, w is cancelled. Now it is a p minus n plus log k base 2, p minus n plus log k base 2. It is given in option B. Option B is the right option here.